Hello, hello, mic test. What's up, everybody? I've got an amazing response on my last two videos on Wallstreetbets Python analysis. The last two videos were on predicting GME's next move and the top most discussed, or I would say hot stocks in the market. If you remember, I left my last video on different prospective trading strategies which can help us make our portfolio go to the moon. So what are these strategies? In this video, we'll see one of these possible sentiment trading strategies. For the detailed, thorough analysis of these trading strategies, follow me on the Patreon. Hello everyone, I'm Ritik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. In this video, we are going to work on the same algorithm that we made in our previous video. If you haven't watched my previous video, then click on this I button to watch it. Also watch this video till the end, and there's an amazing gift for all my subscribers. The strategy behind this analysis is that we will use NLTK library to analyze polarity scores of different comments, and then we will convert it into a trading strategy. It refers to natural language toolkit, and by the way, this is one of the most famous library for natural language processing. Actually, I talked about natural language processing in this video. You can click here and learn more. Also, if you want to read the NLTK documentation, and this is the NLTK documentation, I have dropped a link in the description box. And disclaimer, this is not my investment advice. This is just I'm teaching how to use polarity scores functionality of NLTK library. There are many more functionalities in NLTK itself, and there are many more libraries present for sentiment analysis. So we'll have to do a lot of research to make a final trading strategy. So let's directly jump to our code. If you remember, this is the code. This was the code that we made in our last video. Let me give a very brief summary of this code. We imported Praw library, which is the Reddit library for extracting information from Reddit, and then RE is regular expression, pandas is for data frame of manipulation. This is how we extracted all the information from the Reddit forum, which is Wallstreetbets. I just added these two lines here because I'm using Google Colab here. In my previous video, I used Anaconda JupyterLab, and yeah, we have opened this Nasdaq traded text file, and then it has all the tickers. If you remember, I used it in the last video, and this is how I made the list, the dictionary of all the tickers, and this is the regex pattern that I used, and this is how I appended all the titles and comments of different threads in top category. And then in the end, we made a dictionary which had numbers in front of all the tickers, which represents the number of times it is being discussed in all the titles and comments. And then in the end, we just analyze the top 10 discussed stocks at that time. If you remember, GME, PH, APHA, TLRY, and all these companies were the most discussed stocks, which actually give a lot of more volatility in last 2 weeks. This code is already saved in my Google Drive. For my new viewers, you will very soon get to know how to get a free access of my Google Drive where I save all my codes. So let's make the sentiment trading strategy. As I already mentioned, I'll be using NLTK library for doing this task. So let me import NLTK from nltk.sentiment.reader import sentiment intensity analyzer. I will keep these lines as it is, and I'll be changing this username, actually this password, such that you guys don't use it. You can make your own account over there and use it for your own purpose. Sentiment intensity analyzer is a class which has the functionality polarity scores, which we'll be using for this. Giving you a brief, polarity scores gives us the scoring on the basis of its positivity. So if the comment is, say, this cap is super cool, so this is a positive statement. So in that case, the positive score will be high, or negative scores will be very lower. And there's one more score which I'll be talking about very soon, which is compound. Actually, it is another rating which is provided by polarity scores functionality, which is between -1 and +1. If it's closer to +1, then it's more positive. It's closer to -1, it's more negative. So we will be using that compound score for our trading purpose. So let me just leave these lines as it is, and these lines as it is, because these are the tickers that we'll be using for our strategy. And then these are also the same. Let me just introduce a couple of things here. Regex pattern is equal to this, which is used for taking out the tickers. Let me just provide one more thing, like sentimental core is equal to an empty dictionary. And let me just introduce a dictionary final one is equal to this. This will be the final dictionary that will be using for our final analysis. In order to use the sentiment intensity analyzer class, we'll have to download some packages of NLTK. So we can do it like this: nltk.download Vader lexicon. If you run this cell, this will download the required package here. Perfect. Now let me start with the model, which is Vader is equal to sentiment intensity analyzer. And what I'll have to do is I'll be using the same algorithm here for extracting the comments and the title that we made in the last video. Now let me just put a couple of lines here to make the trading strategy. My Patreon members would already know this strategy because I already posted there, and there are many more strategies that I shared over there. So kudos to my Patreon members. So in this code, I have extracted the title like this, and then comments in these lines, and then for s in strings, phrase nre dot find all regex pattern comma s. Regex pattern actually represents the capital letters, which is the uppercase letters. If you remember, I have done it like this. And then if phrase in all tickers, it means that if this particular phrase is present in all tickers, which is actually the list, not the list, a dictionary of all the tickers which are traded in NASDAQ, then in that case I'm doing this analysis. Let me just comment this for a second and uncomment this break for now. So if this phrase is in all tickers, then let me just write one line for checking the polarity scores. So score one is equal to Vader dot polarity scores, and then inside this s. So what I'm doing here is I'm checking the polarity scores of the first string, which is actually a list of all the titles and the comments. So this s in the first round, it will be title, and then second it will be the first comment, and the third second comment, and so on. So let me just actually print score one and put a break here. It should not here, it should be here, and let's see what's the result. It's perfect. So the in the result, the print score one is actually negative is equal to 0.0, neutral is this, positive is this, and compound is this. So whatever the first title is, I don't know what it is, but the negativity of this title is zero. Neutrality is 70%, the positivity is around 30%, and this score, which is compound score, this is the most important parameter for this analysis, and I'll be using this for making the trading strategy, is 0.4404. The closer it is to 1 plus 1, the positive the comment is, and the closer it is to minus one, the negative the comment is. In an article written on Medium website, the compound score is a metric that calculates the sum of all the lexicon ratings which have been normalized between minus one, which is extreme negative, to plus one, which is extreme positive. Similar to the way I made this hot tickers dictionary, I'll be making this sentimental score dictionary, which is an empty dictionary right now, and then in the end I will be making this final one dictionary. So let me just comment this part and write it like this: like if phrase not n sentimental score, then sentimental score phrase is equal to score one. So it is actually, it is putting the first ticker, which is actually not present in sentimental score right now, and then giving a value of score one, which is actually this value in front of that particular item, actually that particular ticker. So it will be a ticker and then colon and then another dictionary, which will be this one. And actually we are just interested in this one, so I'll have to take out this compound afterwards. So else sentimental score, and then I'll have to do it like this: for key comma, let me just put underscore, and score one dot items sentimental score. I'll be explaining this in a moment, just one second. Phrase key plus is equal to score one key, just one second, sentimental score phrase key. Yeah, I think it's correct. So what I've done here is if it's not present in sentimental score dictionary, then we are making another ticker into the dictionary and providing score one value for that. And if it's already present over there, then what I'm doing here is that I'm adding all the scores for that particular ticker. So score one dot items, this will give me all the items which are actually negative, neutral, positive, compound, and then for key and this underscore is like I'm not using that. So sentimental score, and then phrase is the ticker which is already present in that, and then for all this particular keys, for all these particular keys, I'm adding score one of the new score of this, like ticker, whatever the key value is over there. So if before that it was say 0.00 and now the negative score is say 0.5. So it will be adding 0.5 plus 0.0. So the new value will be 0.5. Similarly, for neutral, it will be an addition of 70.7% and the new neutral score. Now let me comment this break and run this cell. Now let's see what is the sentimental score. So sentimental score. So you can see that for different companies, there are different values for different keys, which is for compound, negative, neutral, and positive. And you can see that all these keys are added for different comments. So that's why it is for some parameters, for some tickers, it's quite large number, and for another, it's very small number and even negative number. So yes, similarly, I'll have to remove this break and have to uncomment these part as well, because I need this hot tickers dictionary as well, because I need the topmost 10 discussed stocks, I would say hot stocks, that we discussed in the last video as well. And then we'll do the analysis for the strategy behind this sentiment. So let me uncomment this. And yeah, one more thing, that if I put a list of the sentiment score, then you can see that we'll have the list of all the tickers. Of course, we'll have to take out this YOLO and other things which are actually not tickers. So yeah, we have got a list of all the tickers here, and then this is how I'll be using here. So ticker one, say, is equal to list of sentimental score. Now I'm only interested to have the compound score, not other parameters, not other keys. So for ticker one and tickers, actually this should be tickers or tickers one, and then let me use this this dictionary, which is empty dictionary, final one dictionary, which will be having only the compound scores. So final one, and then again ticker one is equal to sentimental score ticker one, and then inside that I'm just interested in compound. So what I've done here is, because I'm only interested in the compound scores, this is a list of all the tickers that I mentioned here as well. And then for ticker and tickers, then I'm making another dictionary, which is an empty dictionary right now. And then sentimental score ticker one. So for that particular ticker, I'm just interested in compound. That's it. Very easy. Now let me again run this cell. Perfect. So let's see what is final one now. Final one. You can see that for different tickers, there is a different value of there's a different compound value in front of this. So this dictionary is actually now the final dictionary that we'll be using for our analysis. Now what I have to do here is I'll have to comment this break and then run this particular cell, which will take a lot of time actually, because there are many comments and many titles, and it will be doing all the calculations to get to the final one dictionary. So let me just pause this video for a moment, and then I'll come and just send some time. So yeah, it took around 1 minute to run the code, and let's see what is final one now. Yeah, it is a dictionary of lot of tickers we can see here with different values. Did you see the value of AMC? Maybe this is the most hot stock right now. I don't know, we'll have to do the further analysis here. So yeah, there are many tickers here. Now let me come to this line, which is this one. And if I run this line, I'll see which are the most hot stocks today. YOLO is not a stock here. Let me just take top five in this case. And now if I do it like top picks is equal to this, and then top stocks is equal to just a list of top picks. And then if I run this top stocks, I'll have to put it like this in dot index. If I run this like this, then yeah, I've got the top five stocks. A is not a ticker. Actually, it is a ticker, but I'm quite sure that people have not referred to this company while writing this capital A. I'll have to take it out. So let me just put it like this, six, and then run this cell again. YOLO is not a stock, seven, and then run this, and DD is a stock, which is DuPont chemicals, I guess. Yeah, but so I'll have to delete some of these tickers. Top stocks, and then this is three, and then let's see what is top stocks. Yeah, perfect. 1 2 0 1 2 3 4. Similarly for this, four. Perfect. We have got the list of the top five hot stocks here. Now let's just make a trading strategy, a basic trading strategy with these five stocks only. We can implement it on more stocks, of course, but yeah, I'm just giving an example how we can make a trading strategy on the basis of sentiments. So let's make a pandas data frame, which is final df is equal to pd dot data frame. Inside, let me make a small pd dot series and final one, and then I'm only interested in the top stocks, right? So lock, and then top stocks. Let me see what is final df now. Yeah, we've got this data frame, final data frame, with the value of key in front of it. You can see that for GME and AMC, it's a lot, and then PLTR, RH, and DD. We can make a strategy here by giving more weight for all the stocks which have higher score, because the higher the score, the positive the comments or the titles were, and the lower the score, or if it's negative, then it's actually there's a negative sentiment behind this particular ticker. So a very basic strategy can be made here. There can be many more, but yeah, very basic a strategy which can be final DF weights is equal to final DF and then 0 divided by sum of final DF 0. Let me run this cell and then final DF. Perfect. So this is can be a trading strategy. We can see that, let's see what is the share price of GME right now. It's currently trading and 13% up GME, and then AMC is 15%. This is not a final strategy. We'll have to do back test, worst case scenario analysis, best case scenario analysis, and many more before finalizing the trading strategy. But this is the starting point. If you have any such trading strategy in your mind, then please mention in the comment box. I'll be very happy to discuss it in the next video. Also, I share a lot of different trading strategies with further analysis, like backtest and worst case scenario analysis, best case scenario analysis, portfolio attribution, etc. on Patreon. So consider yourself becoming a Patreon member. It's very cheap, and there are many services that I provide over there. The link is in the description box, and on my Patreon page you can see that there are different levels and different types of services that I provide, such as Patreon only posts, tip of the day, early access to codes, and etc. If you see further levels, then things such as becoming a member of my WhatsApp group, a monthly Google Hangouts, one-on-one voice calls, trading strategy of the month, ultra premium algorithms, some fintech project posts, etc. And I'll be doing a lot more things on Patreon, so just consider yourself becoming a member over there. Whew! Oh, I forgot the gift for my subscribers. So yeah, this code will be saved in my Google Drive, and for all my new viewers, you can subscribe to my YouTube channel and then click on this access to my Google Drive button, and then just provide some basic details. And in the end, I'll be using this email address for giving a free access of my Google Drive, and there's no copyright issue. Everything is for free for all my lovely subscribers. A big shout out to my supporters Bill, Sam, and Edmund for becoming Patreon members, and also thank you so much guys for buying me coffee. If you want to buy me a coffee, then please follow the link which is mentioned in the description box. If you like this informative video, then click on thumbs up, like this video, also share it with your friends, and mention in the comment box your opinion, that is different strategies that we can make. Click here to subscribe and stay tuned for future videos. Over there you can see some of the recommended videos, and yeah, don't forget to support me on Patreon down below. So, thank you so much. Bye bye. See you in my next video.